I'm a morning person, and so I'm up. Well, for us, it's earlier. I'm outside, it's quiet, it's glorious today. It's like 50, probably almost 60 degrees now. The sky is blue, the sun is shining, and Art's looking at me going, I'm not a morning person. So, anyways, I'm outside. I'm gonna go pick some rhubarb, and I'm making a new recipe for some whole wheat oatmeal rhubarb muffins. So, we're gonna try those for breakfast today. Good morning, chickens.
Well, the chickens want a handout.
Yeah. You want some rhubarb leaves? Rhubarb leaves. They're like, what's wrong with all these weeds here? Poor things have to stare at the weeds every day and it tantalizes them. They're just on the other side. Could you just give me the weeds instead of making me look at them? That's one thing, the weeds grow so well because of all the chicken poo. It runs off into the weeds and the weeds go. Should we go for the biggest, Art?
Probably should.
I only need 4 cups. Well, that's probably 2.
Yeah, there's one.
Let's see. I'm another big guy. Although the kids have been picking the big ones. 2. Better get a 3rd one for good measure.
And also, you need to make your rhubarb jelly.
Yes, I do. That look like the 4 cups?
Yes, it does.
When I'm out here and I'm actually up early, I love to check my garden, see if everything's okay. And well, in usual fashion, the rabbit was in my garden and he took out, well, they've been gnawing on these cute broccoli and cauliflower. So he was busy last night. He took out some of this.
And we have one little girl that came outside to check things out. And there's another one.
Oh, and she even got her garden boots on.
Oh, look at that Einstein hair. That is awful.
It's like Mary. Mommy's gonna make some rhubarb muffins for breakfast. Does that sound good?
Yummy.
Yummy. Advertisers want you to think that the newest and the best gadget is what's gonna solve all your kitchen problems. And so I'm thinking, oh, you know, they would want me to use a food processor for this. But the amount of time it would take to A, get the food processor out, B, make sure it's clean, C, use it, and then I have to wash it. It's much more beneficial to just chop by hand with a knife and then be done with it in just a minute or two. I don't want to sound old biddy and old fashioned, but the truth is, if you're trying to have a more minimalistic kitchen, a knife is probably just as fast, maybe even faster than all the new fancy gadgets when it comes to cooking.
But you have an Instant Pot that you glorified yesterday.
All right. I will say that the Instant Pot does make life a little bit easier because you can set the dial and walk away from it.
One of the problems I have with the Instant Pot is it's taking up a huge chunk of real estate on the counter, and it's also giving shelter to too much junk.
Yeah.
So that is a problem with the Instant Pot that we will have to solve.
I actually am going to need a little bit more rhubarb because I'm like at 3.5 cups, and I love rhubarb in my muffins, so we'll have to go back and get another stock. 2 cups of milk, 2 eggs, and, well, 2 teaspoons of lemon juice, but I'm going to just go 1, 2. Good. Now stir it up, kiddo.
And then we're going to put Mary on stirring while Janelle gets her next rhubarb.
1 more leaf. Gotta be careful that you don't pull the...
Whoa.
You have to make sure you don't pull so hard that you pull the root out.
Or that you fall over and get hurt.
Or you fall over and you bunk your head on Grace. Are you all right, Grace? Yeah. Sorry. seems to think it was funny. Do you want to take the leaves to the chickens?
Okay, here you go.
No. You want to hold the rhubarb? No. Oh, you want the fun job. Here's another little piece.
There you go. Just hold it for Mommy. You're doing a great job.
There you go, chickens. Whee! Oh, no, 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 no. That's my rhubarb.
Uh-oh.
No. Don't worry. This all gets washed.
Is there a chicken on the nest?
girls, you can help put the one in each muffin
mommy,
tin. There you go,
Mommy,
yeah, we're just waiting for Daddy to restock our bins of oats and brown sugar because we are out and we can't keep doing the recipe until we get it, right?
Yeah.
We need 1 cup of oil. You can help pour it. Put it in the... We did the egg, milk, lemon juice, oil. Now we need to add a teaspoon of cinnamon.
Cinnamon. Oh, and I got
help. Hang on. Ready? Here we go.
Nice.
You gotta put it in. And scoop it up. Oh, that's not enough. Give it a little shake. All right, Grace, go ahead and put it in the... It goes in the oil right here. Dump it in. There we go. That look good? Yeah. And then we need to add some baking soda. 2 teaspoons of baking soda. There we go. Good. And Mommy's got to get the salt. Oh, no, way too much. Ooh, those would be salty muffins. That's good. Perfect. Thank you. All right, so that just leaves us with flour, oats, and brown sugar. This recipe calls for 4 cups of brown sugar. I'm going to be cutting it back because we're just not going to eat that much. We're not going to eat that much sugar. So I think I'm probably going to do closer to 2.5 cups. There's one.
And my face, Mom.
Of course, we have a little bit extra from Grace helping, too. And we'll do about 2.5 here. Okay, you can go ahead and stir that up, Mary. Well, okay, that's all we need, Grace. 2 cups of oats, so we'll let Grace do one. All right, she looks like she's happy with her tablespoon. Okay, don't whack your sister.
Thanks, Gracie.
1, and we need 2. So, Lydia, go ahead and get 1 more. And the last thing is going to be 5 cups of flour. This recipe calls for whole wheat flour, and we have a lot of whole wheat flour, and it's also better for you. So that's true. You want to dump this one, Grace? Do you want to dump this in?
No.
Oh, you want it in your little cup.
Here, sit down.
Okay, go ahead. That's 2. Thank you, girls. Now Mary, the mixer, she's going to stir it up. Stir it up, stir it up.
Oh. I have big muscles.
You have big muscles?
Yes.
It's looking good, Mary. Mary, I'm gonna quick finish this up.
Yeah.
So it's ready to add the... Wow, you did a really good job.
Yeah.
So we just have to make sure it's all evenly mixed. See how in the bottom there's just a little bit left. Mommy gives it her 1 mommy stir. All right, Lydia, you can go ahead and add the rhubarb.
Like
these look really good, don't they? Just dump the whole thing right in. And there you go. And then scrape out those extra pieces. You know, the nice thing about rhubarb is it's not like blueberries where it's going to fall apart on you. Rhubarb's tough and it can hold up to a lot of mixing with kids. One of the biggest lifesavers when making muffins and help with helpers are these ice cream scoops. And you want the one that has the trigger like this, so it can push the batter out. Now watch this. And it helps. Let me show our viewers and then you can help. So I've lined my muffin tins with paper liners and we're just gonna scoop this up. And this really helps with portion size too, so they're all the same size. And I'm gonna put it in and then squeeze the trigger. And the rhubarb's making this a little chunky, so the first couple times you might have to adjust it to whatever recipe you're making. Ready? Squeeze the trigger. Here we go. Look at that. Muffin liners can be pretty expensive if you buy them at the store, and I used to never buy them. And then my bulk food distributor was selling them at a very, very deep discount. They were 25 cents a box, and there are 500 muffin liners.
That is 6,000 paper cups for $1.50. That's a good deal.
Yes, it was. I gave a lot to my friends. and I still have plenty for myself. Now, not all the time can you find prices that good, but even if you go to your bulk food distributor and buy one box of those, even if it's $3 or $4, it's still far cheaper than buying the Reynolds brand or the store brand, the little boxes of muffin tin liners. And they work, they're exactly the same. They're just for restaurants and bakeries and things like that. And they're far cheaper. And you know what? This mama's sanity is worth a lot. I do not have time to be washing little brown muffin bits out of all of these muffin tins. And these really just help save time in the long run. And I would never do this if I had to buy them at the store full price.
This recipe made extra, so we're gonna need more than the 24.
These go in a preheated 350 degree oven. And Peter already put the first batch in. And there we have 3 dozen muffins. We're gonna bake them for 12 to 15 minutes.
While the muffins are cooking, Lydia's looking for worms in the compost pile.
I like holding them with my hands.
Oh, you found a worm?
Right here.
I think the muffins are done.
Muffins!
Muffins. Let's see if they're done. Oh yeah, those are good now. Okay, that's one. Eat, are you hungry? And those are done. We are ready to eat. Yay!
Here are the muffins. Did you enjoy them, kids?
Yes.
Are they a make again?
Yes.
When I was talking to the kids asking if they were full or not, they said they were stuffed. And it was only 2 muffins. But that's because whole wheat flour seems to fill up my kids a lot more. So in some ways, you've got the oatmeal that's really filling. You've got the whole wheat that's really filling. So 2 muffins of these seem to last longer than in their tummies.